Shall we get started? What now? Who's solely... There have just been new sightings of an extremely powerful mirage. I need for the two of you to take care of it. Terra is already stationed close by. Once she's freed up, I'll tell her to rendezvous with you and help out.
Got it. But there won't be anything left to help with. One of us is gonna take that mirage down first. Wanna make it a race, Cloud?
Not interested.
There's a village. Why don't we ask around about the mirage? Maybe they've seen it.
Hey, question for you. Have you seen an unusual mirage in the area?
Oh, you'd better believe that I've seen it. I've never been so scared in my life. When it came here and attacked the village, I was just about ready to give up all hope.
But that's strange. I don't see a whole lot of damage. Where did the mirage go?
You'll never believe it. The silver-haired swordsman came and drove it off. The way he wielded that long blade of his, it was a sight to behold.
Did you say silver hair? Hey, tell me where he went.
Cloud, we're here to look for a mirage, not a swordsman. Don't get sidetracked.
I'm pretty sure that the mirage retreated to the mountains. The swordsman went the opposite way.
Got it. Thanks a lot. Cloud?
Sorry, but I'm going after that guy. Take care of the mirage.
What? Hey, you can't just leave.
Cloud!
Who is this swordsman?
I've been waiting too long to pick up his trail. This time, I'll...
Cloud! I didn't expect to find you here.
Terra? Oh, yeah. Quistis mentioned that you were close by. Listen. Something else came up. You should go track down Lightning in case she needs your help.
Something came up? You left Lightning to face that mirage all by herself? What could possibly be so important?
Look, there's this guy. I've been hunting him for a while. Now I'm finally right on his heels. I'm not gonna let this chance slip away.
Hunting him? Cloud, you're scaring me. Why are you after this person? Did he do something to you?
He took someone away from me. Forever.
So when you find him, what are you going to do? Will killing him bring back the woman that you lost? This isn't any way to honor her memory. To take your love for her and turn it into hate? Especially when it makes you abandon your friends! You have to decide. What's more important? Is it anger and revenge? All right then. One of us will stick by Lightning. I know what I care about. Her safety.
I didn't...
Yeah, thanks. This one's a real handful.
I bumped into Cloud on my way over. But he said he was busy hunting someone.
It's okay. Just forget about him. Hey! Look out!
Cloud! You came back!
Weren't you out looking for that silver-haired swordsman?
I remembered I had something more important to do. Terra, I'm sorry. I get it now. I almost sacrificed others I care about. Never again. No. I won't lose anyone else I cherish. I swear.
Oh, yeah? So can I take that as official confirmation that you cherish us now?
Yeah. There's not a thing I don't cherish.
Who's this silver-haired guy Cloud's after?
From the sound of it, he passes in and out of this world without belonging to it. Maybe he's an anti-champion.
An ant champion?
No, he'd step on the ants and humans alike, just to see the world sink a little further into chaos.
There are people like that out there?
Maybe you'll bump into him one day in some DL... Oops, forget I said that. At any rate, he doesn't seem to be in this world now, so I wouldn't worry about him if I were you.
Take this! I might have known. You two would try to butt in.
It's good to have you back. Thank you.
Don't think for a second that I've given up on my search. But now that I've got my priorities straight, I won't mess them up.
So, let's go. You can practice your cherishing on the way home.
Is there something wrong, Quistis?
Oh, I just wish I was less busy. I hardly have any time to keep exploring the garden.
Well, there's not much you can do. Still, remember when we moved seed here? Feels like ages ago.
Yeah. We were conducting an airship test flight in the area when, boom, there the garden was.
It was crawling with mirages, but it was worth it for the technology and magic alone. The stuff here is way beyond what we had at the time. A brand new airship engine, this gunblade, the draw tech.
Yeah, but we should have been more careful. The machines went berserk after we gave them to Shinra. In retrospect, Isn't it possible they were connected to the Cogna? We should have done our homework better before handing over our findings.
Hmm? So you're saying that the garden is tied to the Cogna somehow? Isn't that kind of a stretch? I see. You never did give Rain and Lon full access here. Now I know why. Just so you know, they still think it's because you don't trust them.
What do you want me to do? If the garden really is some kind of Cogna haven...
Oh, don't worry. Our friend here isn't like that.
Eiko? Wait, what do you mean, our friend? Do you know something about the garden?
Well, it's really more of a feeling. You know Big Bridge? I think the garden here is very much like him.
Huh? So...
Right. Maybe Balam Garden is just one big barrage. Although, when I reach out to touch its mind, it doesn't respond to me in the slightest. It must be sleeping, way, way more soundly than I have ever seen with Big Bridge. Shall I try waking it up?
Is that a good idea?
I don't think that it means us any harm. But if things do get out of hand...
Got it. We'll deal with whatever comes up.
I guess so.
Why, thank you. Hey. Think you could wake up so we can talk? Can I ask what your name is? Eden. Eden of Balam.
Eden. Oh no! So it is connected to the Cogna?
No. Eden's saying that waking it up opened some kind of pathway to... another world. Usually, it chooses to stay in a deep sleep in order to keep the path closed. That's the only way this world will stay safe.
Either way, we need to send him back.
So, there are places like this where the Cogna can just break through?
I'm no expert. But if the Cogna have already taken over a world that happens to be a close neighbor of Grimoire's... Yuck, it's a scary thing to consider.
Looks like Eden went back to sleep. I think we're okay. The garden should be safe from danger, as long as our friend doesn't wake up.
Got it. We'll take care not to disturb it.
Hmph.
it now. Who?
Cloud, you back here again?
Yeah. With all of these records here, there may be something on the guy I'm after.
What guy?
Ah, impeccable timing, Cloud. This book has given me a wonderful idea, but I'll need your help.
What? An opera?
Not interested.
No way!
Now, not so fast. Celeste, what did you say to me the other day? Because I can recall you lamenting how gloomy the town has been since that whole vampire ordeal.
I might have said something like that, but how does an opera figure in?
With their little hearts broken like that, they may never enjoy a book again.
Sid, it's not that tragic.
Hmm? It's not? Take two. With their little hearts broken like that, they'll never find the courage to fend off all the Cogna.
Oh, well, I suppose you're right about that.
Do you see? This opera is perfect for unslumping the town's spirits.
You don't expect us to.
Yes. It features a mysterious hero and a beautiful heroine. Who could be better for the roles? Back in my younger years, I used to be head over heads for this libretto.
I'm not some opera floozy. I refuse to embarrass myself on stage.
Sorry. But you can count me out, too.
Oh, don't say that. In fact, you can't say that because you're already on the flyers. So as the saying goes, break a leg.
I ought to break your leg for doing that!
Okay, get rehearsing!
What? Hold it!
So, he knows I'm not doing this. Is that her? I think Celeste is serious. Is she gonna do it?
Oh, my hero. Hmm? What do you want? A mirage?
What's going on?
Cloud! This freak fell out of nowhere. Watch it.
Ta-da! It's so quiet in here, I could hear an octopus drop. You can hardly blame me for wanting to take over the place and save it for my retirement. I just flopped in to see who was making all the noise. Nobody arpeggios in my new contagio! Unless she happens to be a deliciously pretty lady.
Who sent you? Was it the Federation?
Nope, never heard of them. I'm here to domesticate, not federate. And any bozo that gets in my way is gonna get mangled. Oh, but the young lady can stay and be my honey pie.
This library is a sacred place. No one gave you permission to disturb it.
Well, if you like your sacred library that much, I'd better do you a favor and hide it from anyone unsavory, huh? Here's a bright idea. Maybe I'll just squirt some ink all over these books.
Keep your tentacles off these books. I need them too. If you won't back off, then I know what's for dinner.
I'm up for a little fancy cuisine myself.
Not you again.
Who, me? Oh, I'm just an innocent passerby. Really?
Oh, got it. Well, in that case...
No one just passes through here, dummy!
Huh? Oh, let's do this!
Not
done yet!
Thank you. Pluto!
Oh, right!
Mama tried to warn me that the real estate market was going to crash.
Seems all the books are still intact. Thanks a lot, Cloud.
I had my own reasons to help. Oh, and Celeste? Is that the libretto?
Hmm?
Oh! It's covered in that freak's ink!
I guess that means the opera's canceled, then.
No, wait a sec! Maybe the duet at the end is still okay!
Well, it's not like we can put on half an opera. Let's just shelve this idea. I'm sure we can find another way to cheer up the townspeople, right?
Oh, well, I suppose.
What a shame, too. You got a nice voice. Anyway, I'm gonna keep hunting through some more of these records.
What do you know? So I wasn't the star of either performance, but that's all right.
Without purpose must be destroyed.
Huh? What do you mean some of the black mages have stopped moving? How could that happen? I thought you were all training together the whole night. A mirage? Came to the training grounds threatening to destroy us all? Does that mean it's time? Hey, remember that conversation we had? About what we're doing in this world? What our purpose is? Our memories only go so far back, you know? To the moment our paths crossed with Rain and Lawn. I think maybe the reason we came to this world was so they could find us. And once our job is done, it could be our lives are supposed to end. Thank you. Yeah, you're right. However we started out, that's not who we are now. Together, we'll drive that creature away.
Golems without purpose must be destroyed.
Tell me, are you the mirage hunting my friends? What do you want? Just leave us alone!
Tools do not have a choice. Tools that are no longer useful must be destroyed.
So much for trying to talk this one out. Come on! We fight!
Golems need to be taught a lesson. Vivi's not a tool. He's a person.
Yeah, and more than that, he's our friend.
Ha!
Ah!
good fight.
Oh, yeah!
That golem said that we were just tools to be disposed of. But that's not true. We chose to fight, and we managed to beat him. We are nobody's tools. Am I not right? Edgar said something to me once, and now it makes sense to me. Don't you see? We don't need a purpose to live. Life is the purpose.
You've come a long way, Vivi.
Right. Come on. Let's go. We all have a job to do. It's up to you and me to keep Figaro's people safe. I know exactly what to live for now. Another day.
Welcome to the... What now? Who's...
None of us know exactly how long it's been, but it's estimated the giants who lived here must have disappeared about 100 years ago.
A century.
Huh. It's a little hard to imagine.
Well, why don't we head back to the airship and...
What the...
Was there something I could help you with, Bahamut? Oh. Or should I call you Tia Babalo?
You dare speak my true name before a stranger? Have you lost your mind?
What is going on?
It's been a century, you said? Been quite a while. But I used to know old Bahamut here.
You know the Dyad servant?
A servant? Me.
Sorry. She means that you once served Lon and Rain.
Ah, yes. Who can forget those two?
What? Lon and Rain are the demon Dyad?
The heralds, probably Siguaridus, must have concocted the name to spice up their crimson prophecy. But there's a basis to it. The original Azure prophecy mentions demons too. Did Lon and Rain know? Could they have read it?
Rain always was a Avernus.
Yes, she was. Except acting out prophecies sounds like Lon.
You know, you're kind of taking all the wonder out of my childhood here.
One thing I know. No one would have started calling them the Demon Dyad or whatever if you hadn't been there, acting like demons and wreaking havoc against their will.
You can blame the heralds for that. I don't care how long I was sealed away. How dare Candelus name his army Bahamut? And declare himself king of this world? I'll kill him! Tell me where he is right this instant!
Is that the reason you're here? Listen, I've observed Brandalus up close for a century, and... Tia Babalo. Face it, you don't stand the slightest chance against him.
What was that?
The X9 Knights. I trust you've heard of them.
They're a fusion of three things. An Esper like me. A human. And lastly, a god from the Extraverse.
Gods from the Extraverse? Espers? What are those?
Well, the Azure Prophecy makes mention of them both. Essentially, it says, from oblivion, light and dark were born. Light begat beings called Espers. Dark begat monsters, and humans who sought the light. In the Extraverse, the world that surrounds ours, live gods that feed solely on death and destruction. Gods that are beings and non-beings, and will not heed reason. One world found a tear in the fabric, and exploited it to confine espers inside their human bodies. However, this tear left them open to the extraverse and its cruel gods.
So then, does that mean the heralds are those exact same gods?
I can't say anything with real certainty yet. In the end, the prophecy is just words. So the best we can do is venture a guess at what it means. In fact, it's because this first section was so ambiguous, it was omitted from copies. Only direct descendants know it.
Then, that would make you...
Yes, that's right. The first summoner's descendant. Oh, and probably the last giant summoner, I would imagine. Although, it seems that some of you have picked up the art of summoning in our place. You'll keep it alive.
Enough! Get to the point! Are you saying that Brandalus has become an X9 Knight?
Yes, that's right. A being who, just like in the prophecy, has crossed dimensions. In a way, what else can you call him but a god? He's completely different from the Brandalus that you think you know. You can't beat him. You can't even touch him.
This cannot be! What you say is impossible! It doesn't matter what Brandalus is like now! He's not me! I'm the true king! The Bahamut King! Tia! Tia Babalo the Great!
Great. I see your temper's as short as ever.
Why are we fighting?
Yamata!
So the demon diehard thing, that was talking about us, huh?
Yeah, I kind of figured as much by now, to be honest.
Oh, Rain. Do I have to remember my past if it's this much of a train wreck?
Well, hang on. From what Wynn was saying, weren't most of our crimes against humanity caused by these troublemakers?
Why don't you ask me? What are you talking about here?
Would you quit it? You really need a lesson in anger management.
I need what?
Oh, also, you should forget about messing with the Heralds. It's true, you can't Wynn.
I shall just have to slaughter you in order to prove how wrong you are.
Thank you. Okay. This can't be. When did you ever gain such strength?
Just a guess, but we must be more powerful than before. This is like our second go at this, right?
Hey, Tia Babalo. You know, we're planning to fight Brandalus. If you come with us, you can have a shot at him.
Now that I've lost, I have no right to refuse. I'm yours!
Did we actually defeat him? A dyad servant?
Huh? Oh. How about that? Lon and Rain have just taken their servant back.
What? Lon and Rain are here? How is that?
I don't know. But that's a good question for when I see them.
Goodbye.